What's going on, YouTube? This is SG1 Sports, and you're watching our college football channel. It's time for our Week 2 playoff eliminator. We've got a couple of eliminations, several teams that are probably eliminated. As we are just getting started, of course, the eliminations will come. And once we get into conference play, they will start coming much, much faster. Of course, so many cupcake games here in the first couple of weeks. But let's get right to it. We're going to start with the teams that were already eliminated heading into week one, I should say. We had every group of five team except for Cincinnati and UCF, just because I think they have the schedule that if they were to run the table, they could possibly get in. Army, UMass, New Mexico State, UConn, those are independent teams that were already eliminated. So now we look ahead to the new eliminations. We've got Cincinnati and Virginia Tech. So those are your two eliminations this week. I realize that Cincinnati lost to a good Arkansas team, a team that should be probably in the top 15. Maybe they finished the top 10. I mean, it could be a great loss for Cincinnati going on the road, but you needed that win. You had to build a resume. And we saw last year, you know, they didn't easily get into the playoffs even when they did go undefeated. So a loss, I'm sorry, it's not going to work. It's not. They had to have that win. Had to go undefeated. And that's the case, I think, any time for a group of five team. At least now, of course, playoffs going to be expanding. And then you could see some group of five teams get in the playoff with a loss. But Virginia Tech also with the loss to a group of five team in Old Dominion. I mean, I guess there is a chance that Old Dominion turns out to be this great team and they go undefeated. And then Virginia Tech wins the rest of their game. I mean, there's really no path. I don't see. You can't overcome a loss to a group of five team. I've always said that. And so for Virginia Tech, unless that group of five team is like undefeated, like I said, undefeated and a top 10 team or something, like Cincinnati was last year. But that's not going to happen. So Virginia Tech, they're out. We have two teams now added to the list of eliminated teams. And then we have some teams that have lost a game that are not out yet, but they're probably out. I mean, it would take a lot for these teams to have a chance. Boston College losing to Rutgers. I don't think you can overcome that. Colorado blown out by TCU. Georgia Tech. No, losing to Clemson's not that big of a deal. But look, for a team like Georgia Tech that's considered to be in the bottom of their conference, for them to climb all the way up the rankings and have a chance in the college football playoff, it's just so unlikely. Same thing with Illinois. They lose to Indiana. They have so far to go. I just don't see the perception, and it's not right, but the perception of these teams will definitely hurt them when those rankings start to come out. Now, let's say that these teams win the rest of their games up until then. I still think the committee's probably not going to rank them very high just because of that perception. Again, that's not how it should be, but it's just how it is. Louisville, just the way, I think you might could overcome that loss, but they got blown out. That's going to be very tough to overcome. And then the same thing with Oregon. Yes, they lost to Georgia, but the way they lost. I don't care if Oregon goes undefeated the rest of the way. I think the committee's going to come back to that game and say, look, we saw this team cannot compete with Georgia, assuming Georgia's in that playoff picture. And I just don't see Oregon. The Pac-12 is going to have a hard time, honestly. I think USC is the only team with a realistic chance. Same thing with Utah. It's going to be tough for them. It's not quite as bad for Utah. Let's go ahead and get to our next teams, and I'll start with Utah. These are the teams that have one loss but are still alive. If they win out, they'll have a good chance to get in. Not guaranteed to get in. But Utah losing on the road in a very close game, week one. Let's say Florida turns out to be a top 10 team. That could obviously help Utah. It's really going to depend on Florida. Utah's fate is in Florida's hands, really. I mean, Utah's got to win out, but they also have to have Florida finish really high. I don't think if Florida finishes 7-5 and Utah runs the table, I don't think Utah's going to get in because they're not going to forgive a loss to a 7-5 team. That's just the way it's been in the past. So I don't see Utah getting in unless Florida has a really good year, and I think for sure Utah has to win the rest of their games. West Virginia, they've got to win the rest of their games, but at least they lost on the road in a close game, kind of like with Utah. They need Pitt to have a good year. Purdue losing a close game to Penn State. They're going to need Penn State to have a good year. Notre Dame is fine. If they run the table, go undefeated, they're probably going to get in over even a one-loss Pac-12 champion, maybe even a one-loss ACC champion, because their loss came on the road to a top-three team in the first game of the season. So Notre Dame is actually still in pretty good shape. Nebraska, it's going to be tough for them. But they have so many. I mean, if you're playing in the Big Ten, obviously, if you run the table and you win your conference, you're going to get in. So kind of circle back to Purdue. I said Penn State had to have a great year. Purdue really just needs to win out. I think Purdue, Nebraska, they control their own destiny. LSU, they control their own destiny. If they win out, win the SEC, they're going to get in. So all these teams still have a path, still have a chance to get in, although it's going to be tough. I mean, Nebraska, Purdue, it's hard to see them winning the rest of their games. West Virginia, same thing. All right, so everyone else still alive. Let's look at the updated playoff picture. And I really didn't make many changes. It still feels like Alabama there at one, Ohio State at two, Georgia at three, based off of the favorites. I would argue that Georgia might be the favorite now, and you could flip Georgia and Alabama, but Alabama's still ranked number one. They're still the favorite. Ohio State's still the favorite, they'll be the favorite in the rest of their games, favorite to win the Big Ten, so they're sitting there at two. Georgia, I mean, they're going to be favored in every regular season game, and again, Alabama might be favored over them in the SEC championship, but that's about it. So I think Georgia would maybe slip down to number three. And then that number four spot, where I picked Miami, and I'm having a hard time. I don't know if I'm going to stick with Miami in my predictions this week. Although they didn't do anything wrong, it's just I'm looking at how bad Iowa was, and that was like the one game where Michigan might possibly lose outside of Ohio State. Well, Michigan's got a great chance to go 11-1 and possibly get in the playoff. Although if it's an 11-1 Michigan versus an 11-1 or a 12-1 Miami team or a Clemson team that wins their conference, Oklahoma, same thing with USC, I think it might be hard for Michigan just because of their schedule. They didn't play a very tough schedule this year, or they won't play a very tough schedule this year, especially in the non-conference. Oklahoma's still the favorites in the Big 12, or you might could put Baylor in there. Those seem to be the two teams that everyone is projecting to win the Big 12. USC now, I think, is the only team with a real legitimate chance out of the Pac-12. I think the losses by Utah and Oregon really hurt that conference. USC going to have to win out. And, you know, they get a big opportunity against Notre Dame at the end of the year. So that could possibly be enough. If they run the table, I think they're going to get in. But even with a loss, I think they have a better chance than on 11-1 Michigan with that big game coming late in the year. Unless you lose that game. You don't want to lose one of those games late in the year. That could cost them. And then Clemson's still going to be the favorite in the ACC. Like I said, I picked Miami in the ACC. As of right now, I'm sticking to that. We'll see how things look as we see a few more games, but Miami, Texas A&M, that's going to tell us if Miami is for real or not. I think they are. I really do. But based off of just who the favorites are, this is kind of what the playoff picture looks like right now. So to be clear, these are not my predictions. This is just what the perception is based off of the favorites and all that. This is just kind of how the playoff picture looks, and I like to do this every week along with the elimination. So that's how it looks right now. We'll see in the next few weeks how this changes. It probably will change. There could be a number four team that becomes clear. Maybe it's Clemson. We'll see. You know, they maybe found something in that second half against Georgia Tech. They're going to be very interesting to see that. A lot of big games coming up as we kind of shape this playoff picture and figure out who the teams are that do have a real legitimate chance. So that's it for the Eliminator this week. Thank you for watching. Let me know your thoughts down in the comments below. And stay tuned for more here on the SG1 Sports College Football Channel.